I get it.
So, you guys, I know we all have a different way of getting our energy in the morning and each day, but you don't have to run in place for 10 minutes. That's not how it works.
Okay.
I do have something that gives me energy. And this may sound odd to you all, but that's words. I like words a lot. They have really cool meanings, and you can do awesome things with them. And, you know, especially words in the Bible or words of praise. So I have a poem that I'm going to recite for you guys today that helps me get some energy. But Aaron's gonna read the poet's words first, explaining what this poem means to him.
I can't say that I'm crazy about this poem anymore, especially with it being the opener for this record and this book. Still, it has a purpose, and it shows where I was at when it was written. This is basically my average day 2 years ago. Now my days are hardly normal, but back then, I was just a regular 21-year-old going to school and working a job that I'd rather not have had. The girl said goodbye. Philosophy was bringing me down, and all I could afford was the same lunch every day. It was a routine day, day in and day out. Beauty is to be found in such circumstances, though. I wrote this poem in the morning and set out to make this particular day unlike all of the others. Sure, I was going to be doing the same things, but now with a different perspective. Sure, I was going to be seeing the same things, but with a different perspective. Perspective was wonder and joy. It's a choice to live such a way despite what so many insist.
Today without that 5 million pound boulder of stress on my chest, and now I feel blessed and I can rest. Oh, the rest these weary extremities that have been inflicted with infirmities unseen or experienced by them before. So tell me, what does the future have in store? I don't know, but I'm just going to let today be today. I'm going to wake up this morning with a smile on my face, look in the mirror, brush my teeth, and not rack my brain wondering if she's going to call me or not, because when a girl says, let's just be friends, what she really means is, I'm never going to talk to you again. Accept it. Move on. I just did. And after that, I'm going to put on my play clothes, go in the front yard and climb that pecan tree. But not like last week when I got halfway up there and started debating what morality is. A social adaptation? A product of evolution? Or put there by God? I'm just going to climb that thing and have fun like I did when I was a kid. And after that, I'm going to go to vertebrate zoology class and listen to my boring, lifeless instructor talk about how there are over 50 different species of minnows in Arkansas alone. But I'll smile and nod and show interest, act interested, because that really is interesting if you think about it. Think about it. And after that, I'll go home and have lunch. The same old lunch again, two more frickin' frozen El Monterey Jack bean and cheese burritos with a glass of distilled water and an orange. But I'll give thanks that I do have food to eat, because so many people don't. And after that, I'm going to work and paint, but I'm not going to paint that boring eggshell white on the old lady's wall like she requested, no. Not going to do it. I'm going to pretend I'm a juvenile Leonardo da Vinci and paint a stick figure masterpiece of a young couple frolicking in the fields of flowers with little butterflies and gophers popping up here and there. I'm sure the old lady will appreciate it later in life. And after that, I'm going to have dinner with my pawpaw. And when he cries to me about how his arthritis is bad, his own daughter rejects him, he's sad, I'll put my arm around him and listen and watch his weary eyes glisten as he experiences my love for him. And then after that, I'll go home, sit on the floor and start singing songs to the one who gave me this joy and this feeling. But it's more than just some fleeting feeling. It's internal truth in which I am reeling. And then at night, I'll lay my head to rest without the slightest bit of fright or fret, knowing that I made the day the best I could and that God truly is good.